And I'm, of course, particularly pleased to welcome Dr. Fauci back to Villa Firenze, to the Italian residence. Bentornato, Dr. Fauci. Let me just say a few words about Italy. Italy was a country hit very hardly by the pandemic. At the very beginning, we were really the most challenged country in Europe and probably in the world by the pandemic. And today, after a year and a half, because we followed science, because we trusted science, and also because science was supported by a very impressive logistic endeavor, we are today really in a much better position. Italy is a country that has a very good record of vaccination. Our population under over 12 years old is vaccinated at 75%, more or less, which is really, I think, impressive.
So I want to take this opportunity to say how impressed I am with my Italian internal medicine and hospitalists in Italy who so extraordinarily bravely handled what we all know now as a historic pandemic, the likes of which we have not seen in well over 100 years since the historic pandemic of influenza in 1918. Italy got hit much more severely right before the United States did. And we learned a lot from our colleagues. I remember getting on the phone to people who I actually had trained, who now were in hospitals in Milano, in Genoa, in Rome, and were hearing from them things that were actually important information that helped us in our ultimate treatment of individuals. And the Italians have done an extraordinary job, not only in the giving first class, state-of-the-art care to patients with COVID in Italy, but also setting an example for the rest of the world. Also, in the arena of vaccinations, I heard from Madam Ambassador that for individuals 12 years old and older, you have over 70% of that population is now fully vaccinated, which quite frankly is even better than us here in the United States. So again, in the arena of not only clinical medicine, but in how you have rolled out your vaccine program. You mentioned something about following the science. When I first accepted the position as the primary medical advisor to President Biden, he told me something that is true to today, that we will always follow the science no matter where it takes us, and we will make scientific evidence and data what drives everything that we do. And I know that that's exactly what's going on in Italy. So I want to congratulate my Italian colleagues that you are in unison with us. And it's something that we will do together as brothers and sisters. So I just want to tell you how much I appreciate, again, being here and receiving this prestigious award. But it gives me another opportunity to strengthen the bonds that I feel so strongly with Italy and with my Italian colleagues. So thank you so much. I truly appreciate it.
Dear Dr. Fauci, it is a pleasure and an honor that you have accepted to receive the FADOI Internal Medicine Award 2021, which the Executive Committee of my society has decided unanimously to confer to you. Internists, we have provided and are still providing care for over 70% of COVID-19 patients hospitalized in Italy at multiple levels of complexity, including non-invasive ventilation and sub-intensive care to prevent intubation and subsequent transfer to intensive care units. We dealt with very many problems, organizational, scientific, and above all, human, death, illness, disability. difficult period we have faced, during which scientific reference and or guidelines were often lacking, we have always found in the words and in the papers of Dr. Fauci a fundamental inspiration for our clinical daily activity. Very often an answer to our clinical problems, a guide, a reference. The right way that the ambassador said, according to science, following the science. For this reason, we are very grateful to Dr. Fauci. Our award consists in an ancient astrolabe. This is a symbol dear to our physicians who always can find the right path. And this is the motivation of the prize that I'm going to read. To Dr. Anthony Fauci, for the invaluable contribution to promote medical knowledge and clinical experience in the field of internal medicine and infectious diseases. From Italian internists, with gratitude and appreciation for his fundamental inspiration in their clinical practice.